Hello everybody, last week I was working on C++ wrapper for SDL, and I was looking for different wrappers for SDL, and I do not need too much from wrapper. I just want to have some nice C++ features, like using AII. So like I always forgetting to release to destroy texture, for instance, and I want to do compiler for me, these kind of things. And in our one, several tutorials I was using some existing wrapper, but I realized it requires compilation and all these kind of things. So I decided to have header only wrapper for SDL2, and it's only one HPP file, and actually it's not very big, it's only 364 lines, and I added some interesting features for events, but everything else like looks more or less normal. So let me demonstrate to you wrapper. So let's make, so I have it here, and there is only one file, and also I was trying to write readme, but actually readme is going to appear way bigger. Probably I will try to figure out how to make it way smaller, just probably give some general idea around SDL, and you can just use documentation from SDL2 and be able to figure out how to use this wrapper. But also I'm thinking probably this video is going to be documentation, sort of documentation for the library. So it's wrong file, this is too many Emacs instances running. Here's it. So here's the library, and let's create the directory sdlppdemo, and I will copy or even just make the symlink. So making symlink, so it's scopy symlink to sdlppdemo. So, and also I choose quite simple license, it's MIT license, it's very simple and friendly for a lot of things license. So here's it, HPP file, and let me grab some make file, pdemo. So this is my standard make file. I already explained in different tutorials how this make file works. And let's make main.cpp, and what we need to do, include sdlpp.hpp int main. I still need to do these things for Windows and to initialize SDL. So first of all, everything is inside the namespace SDL, and then I need to create the instance init, and here is it. I can use now SDL2 documentation. So just go here, come on. I need to go to wiki actually, category. So initialization, and here is it. I can do this thing, or I can do this thing, SDL init everything. So let's do. And I do not need to do SDL quit, it will do SDL quit automatically. Then I want to make window, so same thing, it's a class window, and for constructor for window I need to go to Windows management, and here's it, create window. So, and all these parameters I can use to create the window. So let's make the SDL2 demo, and then XY WH, and let me grab from existing tutorials. I mean, so here's it, all these parameters, So X, Y, width, height, and borderless. And for width and height, I'll put hard-coded values 720. So it will create windows and automatically destroy it, and then it will call SDL quit at the end. So quite nice. So now I can create renderer, and for creating renderer we can see, so let's go documentation for renderer. So here's it, create renderer, and it takes parameter window. So to get the pointer for window, I overloaded ampersand, so doing this thing it will return pointer to SDL window. Now index negative 1 and flag 0, right? So this is standard thing for supporting, and then 0 renderer flux, and default is accelerated and so on. So now I can do loop for to done. And actually, you know, I will make done outside false and do while not done, like this. I want to have this thing outside because I will use my event handler, which is I want to also have outside, because I don't want to call constructor for event handler. So SDL handler E, and then event handler has wait, follow link. So it has different events and like event callbacks. So one of them I'm looking for, it's a quit. So let's have quit equals, and I'll have lambda here, and I will capture done, and then it takes SDL quit event of this thing. So this thing we can find in also in SDL2 documentation, and it's in the input event handling. So we can have SDL event, and here's it, all different types of events, and one of them is quit event. And quit event will have object SDL quit event, which has some parameters like timestamp of event, basically that's it. So we are not interested of this thing, so we do not need to have. And here's it, I grab done, and I can set done, I capture done to true. And then I can call pump or pull, right? Pull event like this. And then I can do r present, r clear, r set draw color. Let's do black. 0, 0, 0. What is it? It's not pull. Functions pull with all. Here's it. So now we should see black screen, and on closing it should close. SDLPP demo. So here's it. We see black screen, and then I'm pressing Alt F4, it should close the window. So what kind of things we can do here? We can have also textures. So let me create the texture, SDL texture T, and it needs R. And let's see again to documentation for texture. So it's 2D accelerated. Texture, create texture, so it takes renderer, format, access, W and H. So for format, I want to have 32-bit, so something like this, and then what kind of parameters? Access, for access, I want to have static, and for width and height I want to have 1280 by 720, right? And then let me pull some picture. Nice picture. What do you like? Let's search for cats. Yeah, let's take this one. So let me come on, view image, save image here, and then I'll run GIMP. So I need to resize image to make it 1280 by 720, and save as BMP. So export to here cat.bmp, and yeah, with RGB. Okay, let's have it RGB. Okay, so we have a picture. I did not implement part for pixel format and convert like this thing in SDL. So not this thing. Where is it? Yeah, surface creation and simple drawing. So I need to do unfortunately C style programming, but I think it's fine. Auto surf equals SDL load BMP cat.bmp, and if not surf throw runtime error not load cat.bmp, and SDL 3, so here. And then surface has I think I can lock it, or I do not need to lock this thing. Oh yeah, here's it, lock surface, and unlock surface. So lock surf, unlock surf, right? And then I have access to pixels and t dot. So now I can load all these pixels to the texture. So how I can do this thing again? Video update texture. So in update textures, so let's do update, and then it here, and pixels, it's a surf dot pixels, and pitch surf dot pitch, simple pitch. So it's RGB, so I'll do RGB. And do I need to do this kind of thing? Right. I need to do free, right? Free surface, okay. Free face. Okay, let's see. And now drawing part, right? So to draw, now I do not need these things. Copy T, no Peter, no. Something not right. Probably I need this thing. Let's try again. Nope. A B R, this thing like this. It looks like it's totally ignoring my format, which is interesting. format. Let me do format. So I'll do surf Format. Yay! Now it works. So, and now we can just, I don't know, let's try to draw something on top. Vector, where, int, pixels, and we can draw here for auto p, and actually we can use SDL point p pixels r draw line, category deaccelerated polygon. Where is it? Draw points, draw lines, draw line, draw lines, draw point. This function to draw a series of connected lines in the current target. Okay, draw lines. So actually, draw lines and pixels data, pixel size. So I need vector, pixel size, and then on I can do e mouse move equals pixels const SDL mouse move event, I guess. Let's see. So let me see what does it have. Move. Ah, motion. Mouse motion. Okay. Mouse motion. Motion. Yep. And here we will do pixels push back. SDL point x e y. Okay. So now on mouse move, it should draw lines here like this. Anyways, I think I covered quite a lot of things. For to do, I need to do C++ interface for surface. I don't think I will use it too much in my kind of production code. Probably I will use this thing a lot in some in my tutorials. But using bitmaps, you can see like bitmaps are quite big, like this 1280 by 720 bitmap is almost 3 megabytes, so it's better to use PNG for instance. And for this thing, I'm using some libraries to load PNGs. What I did not cover here, I did not cover audio, and audio is kind of a similar thing. So you just create audio device, and there is one thing, it's for callbacks, but it's kind of similar as here. Probably I will do separate video how to how I implemented wrapper for audio in my library. So I think that's it for now. You can get the library here on this address, github.com/AntonT/SDLPP. So that's it. Thank you for watching, and hopefully see you next time. Bye.